guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today's topic is V-Ray render settings. V-Ray 5 render settings are quite easy because most of the work is already done for you. If you are still using previous versions of V-Ray, I strongly recommend to update it now. But these V-Ray 5 render settings will work on previous versions of V-Ray Next 2. In this V-Ray render settings tutorial, you will learn how to quickly set low resolution settings for test renders, how to set light cache progressive image sampler, V-Ray denoiser render element, how to quickly set resolution settings for final quality renders. Bonus tip. So without any further ado, let's get started. Selecting the V-Ray renderer. In order to use V-Ray 5 renderer, you need to select it as your current renderer. Open the render settings window by clicking here. Next, set render using to V-Ray. With the introduction of the new V-Ray denoiser and progressive image sampler, I will say the best option to render low or high resolution images is brute force, light cache, denoiser, and progressive image sampler. How to set low resolution settings for test renders. Click the render element tab, select denoiser and click add. Next, click GI tab. Open GI rollout. Make sure your secondary bounce engine is set to light cache. In V-Ray 5, the primary bounce engine is by default set to brute force GI. But if you are using previous versions of V-Ray, then make sure to set your primary bounce engine to brute force. Now open light cache rollout. Change subdivs to 500. Next, open V-Ray tab. Open image sampler rollout. Make sure sampler type is set to progressive. Change noise threshold to 0. Max render time. It sets the maximum render time in minutes. And after reaching this time, V-Ray will stop rendering the image. Let's set the value to 1 and render. You can see that the image stops rendering approximately at 1 minute and 9.2 seconds. It's okay if your render takes few seconds more because it has to apply denoiser and finalize image settings. But if you watch closely, we have noise here. Next, set the max render time to 3 and render. You can see that the V-Ray has stopped rendering at 3 minutes and 8 seconds. Compare both results. The result has improved from the previous render of 1 minute, but still it has some noise here. You can see 1 minute, 3 minutes. When my result was 1 minute, it has some noise here and some here. But when I increase my render time to 3 minutes, you can see that the noise is removed or it is less than before. You can keep increasing the max render time to make the results better. But in test rendering, we have to do a lot of renders to check lighting and shading. Therefore, I normally don't care about the quality of the image and want fast renders. So set the render time between 1 to 3 minutes and enjoy quick renders. I normally set my to 1 minute. How to set high resolution settings for final images? Since we have changed the V-Ray render settings from default, so first I will reset it to default V-Ray render settings. In V-Ray 5, go to Presets, Import Render Settings, click Default Settings, and it will reset all the settings back to its original. In V-Ray Next, go to Presets, Load Presets, Default Setting, and this will reset it to default. Next, click Render Elements and add V-Ray Denoiser. If it is already added, then select it from the Edit Render Elements list and remove it. And add Denoiser again to change its settings back to default. Next, select V-Ray Denoiser. Click on Attribute Editor. Open Extra V-Ray Attributes. Change the preset to Mild. If you remember, in low resolution settings, we keep the preset to default value. But this time we are keeping the mild preset. The reason for this is that denoiser detects the area where noise is present in the rendered image and smooths them out. Let's see an example. If I turn off my V-Ray denoiser, you can see I have this much noise in my rendered image. But when I apply the denoiser, it actually smooths this noise and give me a nice looking result. Since we are rendering high resolution images, so I keep the mild preset, which is less smooth than the default preset. Next, click GI tab. Open GI rollout. Set secondary bounce engine to light cache. If you are using V-Ray 5, then your primary bounce engine is already set to brute force GI. But if you are using previous versions like V-Ray Next, then you need to set your primary bounce engine to brute force, just like we did in low resolution settings. Now open light cache rollout. If you are rendering full HD images, then for exterior images with normal details, I keep the light cache between 1500 to 2500. For exterior images with high detail, I keep the light cache between 2000 to 3000. If you are rendering extremely high images like 4000 into 4000 or greater, then make sure your subdivs of the light cache is not less than half of it. Example, for 4000 into 4000 pixel image, set your light cache between 2000 to 4000. For our image, I will set it to 2500. One more thing, if you are doing animations, then change the preset from still to animation and make sure your subdivs are high. Next, click V-Ray tab. Open Image Sampler Rollout. Image Sampler Rollout is extremely important as it impacts the render quality versus render time of your image. The main purpose of image sampling is to improve anti-aliasing. If you don't know about anti-aliasing, let me know in the comments. I will tell you about it. Since the introduction of V-Ray Next, we have Progressive Sampler, which renders the whole image progressively in passes and improves the detail with each pass like this. You can see the passes. As the passes are increasing, this image is becoming more and more clear. You can still do the bucket rendering, but now I use progressive rendering because I can see the whole image progressively as it renders. Plus, progressive image rendering is easy to use. The only two parameters to adjust in progressive rendering are noise threshold and max render time. Again, set the noise threshold to 0. As we have already seen in test render section, that max render time sets the maximum render time in minutes, and after reaching this time, video will stop rendering. Let's set the max render time value to 1 minute and render. You can see that the image stops rendering after 1 minute and 7 seconds, although our image is noisy. Now set the value to 5 minutes and render. Again, we can see that the image stops rendering after 5 minutes and 4.2 seconds. The result is improved from the previous time. We can keep increasing the render time like this to improve the results. But if you are doing final renders and render time is not a problem for you, furthermore, you want full image quality without noise, then disable render time by typing 0. Reset the noise threshold value back to its original value of 0.01. This is the value when you first open V-Ray. Noise threshold. It sets the desired noise level in the image. Since the render time is disabled, therefore, V-Ray stops rendering when the image threshold value of 0.01 is reached. Lower noise threshold will give better results but increase render time. So, if you want to decrease noise and increase image quality, then decrease noise threshold value to 0.005. Mostly, this value gives you a good result. Render and compare. You can clearly see that the image quality has improved a lot with noise nearly gone. But look at the render time. It is 14 minutes and 55 seconds. So here is the summary of high quality render settings. Set brute force to default values. Light cache between 1500 to 3000, V-Ray denoiser to mild preset. In progressive image sampler, either set render time or use noise threshold between 0.01 to 0.005. You can go less than 0.005 too, but normally you get a good value between 0.01 to 0.005. Before I give you my final bonus tip, I would like you guys to check out my two other playlists. V-Ray for Maya and V-Ray Next for Maya. They have simple to follow V-Ray tutorials for Maya with easy explanation. Almost all of my V-Ray Next tutorials will work with V-Ray 5 too, but if some option changes in V-Ray 5, I will mention them in comments too. For example, Maya, best way to start learning V-Ray Next for beginners. If you go down the top comment, in the top comment I mention, V-Ray Quick Settings dialog box has been removed from V-Ray 5 and GI is turned on by default. So, if you are using V-Ray 5, then skip section 3, V-Ray render settings between 2.57 to 4.08 and move to section 4. So it means if you are watching V-Ray 5, then you don't need to watch this V-Ray quick settings. Else everything you will find in V-Ray 5. Now the last bonus tip. How to bring down intensity of V-Ray highlight burn. Like here, you can see the highlights, they are burning. Till V-Ray next, if I want to bring down the intensity of this highlight burn, I normally go to render settings, color mapping, change my type to exponential, HX3 exponential, or decrease the burn value of Reinhardt. This is totally okay, but it has one disadvantage. If I want to change the highlight burn, I have to render again. But in V-Ray 5 frame buffer, you don't need to change the color mapping at all. Instead, go to V-Ray frame buffer layers, click on this plus sign, add exposure, and start decreasing your highlight burn. Just keep watching this place while I keep decreasing the highlight burn. You can see how easily I can control it. If I turn off my exposure, you can see the previous result and my new result. I can easily control it as much as I want. And I don't have to render the scene again. If you guys want to know the difference between exponential, HSV exponential or Reinhardt, just let me know in the comments and I will tell you this too. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. If you like my video, give it a like. If you love my video, subscribe to my channel, share my video and comment below. Bye bye guys.